Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the first Ashland Legion Post 77 baseball home game of the season as 0-1 Post 77. Welcome in Newton Post 440. Tom Nappy on the call and on camera today is Connor Donovan. You are tuned in to Ashland Legion Baseball on WACA-TV in Ashland and HCAM Television in Hopkinton. It is a beautiful sunny day here. Temperatures are in the high 70s, low 80s, and it is absolutely a gorgeous day for baseball here at Ashland High School. Post 77 will be playing their first couple home games here at the high school field due to commitments at the middle school field, but they will be back at the middle school field for their third home game of the season. But a nice new facility here at Ashland High School and a nice new playing field that was installed for last season, as last season was the first season that this field was played on. Let's take a look at the Ashland Post 77 field. On the mound for Post 77 is Andrew Keim, making the start today. Keim is from Holliston High School, and he is a right-handed pitcher set to pitch the second game of the season for Post 77. Zach Jacobs is the catcher for Ashland. He's also from Holliston High School. Jake Obid is over at first base. Another player from Holliston High School. You got Michael Krupe at second base. He's from Ashland High School. Mike Messier is a 2015 graduate of Hopkinton High School. He is your shortstop. Ronan Bates is at third base. He's from Ashland High School. And then from left to right, you have Mitch Porter from Ashland High School. Brad Seymour, who is also from Holliston High School. And Samir Sharma is the right fielder. He's from Deerfield Academy, but lives around the Post 77 area. So is going to be playing some Legion baseball for this Ashland team. Post 77 lost a tough pitchers matchup in their first game of the season. It was on the road against Hudson. The final score was 1-0. A great pitchers duel between Kyle Sullivan for Hudson and Miles DeSoni for Ashland. DeSoni took the loss but pitched a gem. He went all seven innings, gave up one run on five hits, had seven strikeouts and three walks. Mike Messier had a double, and Jake Obid had a single for Ashland Post 77. But Hudson ended up with the victory as the lone run was scored in the bottom of the seventh inning. Evan Schmidlein Evan Schmidlein scored the run as pinch hitter Sam Rosenfeld hit a double to drive in the winning run for Hudson and give them the 1-0 victory over Ashland as the first pitch to the shortstop for Newton, Jack Marsjanic, is low for ball one, a 1-0 count. We'll get you the Newton lineup in just a moment as that pitch is low as well. 2-0. Jack Marsjanic, the shortstop, leading things off for Newton. Alex Haslam, the center fielder, will bat second as this pitch is a little bit low as well. Keenan Uliano, the third baseman, hitting third. Mike Butera, the right fielder, in the cleanup spot. Christian Quigley, the DH, batting fifth. Don Procopio, the first baseman, batting sixth. Brendan Devlin, the left fielder, batting seventh as there's a strike. Mike Gately, the catcher, batting eighth. Bill Sylvie, the second baseman, batting ninth. And Spencer Anderson is the pitcher for Newton. As Andrew Keim is set to deliver, and this is hit in the air towards deep center field. And ranging over, playing deep, is Brad Seymour for the first out of the game. One away in the top of the first, and that will bring up Alex Haslam, the center fielder. Well, it is our pleasure for the third season to bring you Ashland Post 77 Baseball on HCAM Television and WACA-TV in Ashland. As Haslam steps in and awaits the pitch from Keim. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. Andrew Keim, a very good player for Holliston and can be used all around the field, really, as he delivers here, and that is just outside, 1-1. Newton playing their first game of the season. They actually had to postpone their first three games as Newton North made the Super 8, as this is up the middle, played by the shortstop, throw to first, and Haslam beat it out just in time. Nice run up the line by Haslam. The throw from Messier a little late. And that'll bring up Keenan Uliano with one out and a runner on first. And that was some serious speed coming down the line by Haslam. That ball was well played by Messier. Good throw across the diamond. But some great speed on display by Haslam. As a check-in at first, runner back. Uliano, the third baseman, awaits the pitch. Keim now delivering from the stretch. As there's a strike, grabs the inner corner. 0-1. Runner with a small lead at first as Keim set to deliver. And this is up the middle, past the reach of the second baseman, Krupe, into right field. And there's two runners on with one out. A single by Keenan Uliano. And that will bring up the cleanup hitter, right fielder Mike Butera. As Zach Jacobs, the catcher, going to head out to the mound to have a discussion with Keim. And it will be a quick discussion. As Butera set to step in. And Newton went all the way to the final eight in the state and got eliminated the other day, Newton North, but they had a very good season. A lot of talented athletes on this post 440 team as that pitch inside, 1-0. Keim from the stretch. Runner leading off of first as there's a strike, 1-1. Early on, Keim's pitches have a good amount of movement. And he delivers here, fastball fouled away, 1-2. Well, you cannot ask for better weather than this for the first home game for Ashland Legion Baseball. As Keim set to deal. That one down low. Nice job by Jacobs keeping it in front. Runners will stay put. Two and two on Butera. Keim delivering from the stretch, runners both taking a small lead. Up the middle, right to the second baseman, throw to second for one, throw to first is not going to be in time. Another runner trying to come home, he'll score. 1-0, Newton. Alex Haslam taking advantage of the situation, comes all the way from second base to score. Uliano thrown out, heading to second, but Butera will end up with an RBI. And it is 1-0, Newton. And that is going to bring up Christian Quigley with a runner on and two outs. Sounds like a fielder's choice RBI there. As there's a strike, a swinging strike. Newton will certainly take it. That is a situation you do not see a whole lot. And that was well played by Newton. Soon as that throw was heading to first, Haslam turned past third base and just went directly home with no hesitation. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. In that situation, it worked. As this is up the middle, and that'll get by the shortstop, and it is going to be a single. So Butera moves up to second, Quigley to first on the single, and that'll bring up Don Procopio, the first baseman. Two on, two out, it's a run in for Newton. Newton North High School was known for their hitting, and they're trying to continue that here. A lot of Newton North athletes on this team as there's strike one to Procopio. In fact, the majority of the team is made up of Newton North players. There's strike two, 0-2. Head coach for Newton is James Greeley. As that one is down low, nice block by Jacobs. 1-2 count. Newton always tough when it comes to Legion ball. That one inside, 2-2 on Procopio. Keim from the stretch. And that is fouled away, rocketed into the woods. That's one of the big flaws with this field. You lose a lot of balls into those woods, as they just surround the field, and it is nearly impossible to track them down as there's a huge drop-off. But they certainly try to track them down if they can. And that's strike three, so Keim does get his first strikeout of the day. That'll be out number three in the top of the first, but Newton does play to run. And as we head to the bottom of the first, it is Newton 1, Ashland nothing. Bottom of the first inning, Ashland Post 77 coming up for their first time this season at home. Let's take a look at their lineup. Jake Obit, the first baseman, starting things off as he steps in, set to face Spencer Anderson, as the righty is just about set to deliver. Get you the rest of the lineup in just a moment. Up the first base side, that'll get through. And that is going to be a single for Obit. Nice way to start things off for Post 77. That'll bring up Mitch Porter, the left fielder. So Jake Obit batting first baseman. He just reached on a single. Mitch Porter, the left fielder, batting second. Andrew Keim, the pitcher, batting third. Zach Jacobs, the catcher, hitting cleanup. Mike Messier, the shortstop, hitting fifth. Ronan Bates, the third baseman, hitting sixth. Michael Krupe, the second baseman, hitting seventh. Samir Sharma, the right fielder, hitting eighth. Brad Seymour, the center fielder, hitting ninth. As this is up the middle, takes a couple hops on the infield. Grass fielded by the second baseman. Throw to second, they get one. So Porter reaches on the 4-6 fielder's choice, one away. That'll bring up Andrew Keim. So Keim about to step in. Pretty good hitter as well as pitcher. Anderson set to deal. And the lefty delivers strike one. Hard throwing lefty is Spencer Anderson. Runner leading off of first. Another fastball hit up the middle, and it is fielded over on the third base side, and they will end up getting the out at second base. So Keim will reach on the 5-4 fielder's choice, two away. That'll bring up Zach Jacobs as the catcher steps in. Anderson set to deliver. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Anderson tends to throw it right down the pike and encourages contact from his hitters. Really relies on his defense. As that one's fouled away, 0-2. but he does have a lot of velocity on his pitches, as he will take time to tie up his cleat. As the catcher set to step back in. Post 77 with some new jerseys this year. They got the Post 77 on the front of them rather than Ashland. Some nice navy blue. Is that breaking ball up high? With the white numbers and lettering and the red outline. And of course the Legion slogan on the sleeve. Anderson set to deliver. And this is fouled away. I wasn't sure if that got a piece of him there. Count remains 1-2. Head coach Derek Johnson in his second season as the Ashland Legion head coach, assisted by Scott Soderberg and Brendan Thurber, who may be familiar from last season as he was a player. And that is third base side and called foul. Count remains 1-2 on Jacobs. Keim will go back to first base. Two outs in the inning, two straight fielder's choice by Post 77. Anderson awaits the sign, the leg lift and the pitch, and that is third base side and foul. Count remains 1-2. If Jacobs reaches, Mike Messier would be due up on deck. Anderson set to deliver. That one up high, throw down to first. They nearly got Keim. 2-2. Anderson set to deliver. And this is third base side foul. Nice battle going on here between the cleanup hitter and Spencer Anderson. As we are here on the bottom of the first inning, a 1-0 lead for Newton. Leg lift and the pitch, and this is third base side, and this is fair. Throw to first in time. A 5-3 ground out for Jacobs, and after one inning of play, it's Newton 1, Ashland nothing. We're heading to the top of the second on WACA and HCAM. Top half of the second inning as Newton will come back up to the plate. 7, 8, and 9 due up. Brendan Devlin, Mike Gately, and Bill Sylvie. As Brendan Devlin, the left fielder, set to step in. A 1-0 lead for Newton. As Andrew Keim set to deal. Wind up and the pitch, down low. One and oh. Keim set to deliver. That went up high. There's a strike grabbing the outside corner. 2-1 count on Devlin. Swinging strike, nice breaking pitch by Keim. 2-2. That's fouled away into the backstop. Count remains 2-2 on Brendan Devlin. Devlin at a Waltham High. As that will make the count full. Leg lift and the pitch from Keim, and this is hit in the air, a high fly ball over to left field, and ranging under it, battling the sun and making the catch is Mitch Porter. One away. That'll bring up Mike Gately, the catcher. Leg lift and the pitch. There's strike one. And this game seems to have the makings of a nice pitcher's duel today. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air towards left field. Over to Porter once again, and he makes the catch. Two away. That will bring up Bill Silvey, the second baseman. There's a strike. Wind up and the pitch. Strike two. Leg lift and the pitch. That one down low. One and two count on Silvey. Bill Silvey's first year with Newton post 440. That one up high, two and two. If Silvey reaches, Mars Janik, the shortstop, the leadoff hitter will come up. Keim deals, and this is a high liner over to the second baseman, and it is caught with no problem by Krupe. And that is the third and final out of the top half of the second. As we head to the bottom of the second, Ashland trailing 1-0. Bottom of the second inning, Mike Messier stepping in. 2015 Hopkinton graduate. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Last year of eligibility for Legion Baseball. As Anderson set to deal. Leg lift and the pitch. Fouled away. 0-2. Messier had a nice season for Ashland Legion last year. Played a key role on that post 77 team. That one inside. They just missed the playoffs last year. 1-2 count as Anderson set the deal. 5, 6, and 7 coming up this inning for Ashland. That's fouled away. Anderson delivers on the ground up the middle, and Anderson will underhand it to first, a little high, but in time. A 1-3 for Messier, one away, Ronan Bates to the plate. Ronan Bates out of Ashland High School will graduate next year. That one down low. Ashland High School had a nice baseball season. They made the postseason. on the ground up the middle, fouled away. They finished second in the TVL behind Medway. Overall record was 15-5. 1-1. Leg lift and the pitch. And this takes a couple hops on the infield grass. Handled by the first baseman, flipped to the pitcher. Nice coverage by Anderson, two away. Could score that 3-1. That'll bring up Michael Krupe. Second baseman set to step in. Anderson deals, and that is foul. 0-1. Wind up and the pitch. Just low. Anderson delivers, just outside, 2-1 to Krupe. Anderson gets the sign and deals. Breaking pitch, grabs the outside corner, 2-2. And there's strike three. That'll retire the side on the bottom of the second. To the top of the third we go. Newton leading Ashland 1-0. Top half of the third inning. Top of the order coming up for Newton as Jack Marsjanik, the shortstop, steps in. Wind up and the pitch. Turns the hitter away, 1-0. Set the deal. Up the middle and fielded by the second baseman. High throw to first, and that is going to slip out of the glove of Obid. That was a tough play to make for Krupe. But pretty good field coverage there. So Marsjanik reaches on the single. Alex Haslam will come to the plate, the center fielder. This is Marsjanik's first year as well. Four posts, 440. As Haslam takes strike one. Alex Haslam from Newton North High School graduated this year. From the stretch is Keim. He deals. Up the middle, fielded by the shortstop, flipped to second for one, throw to first, not in time. But a nice job getting the lead runner there, so Haslam will reach on the 6-4 fielder's choice, one away. And now Keenan Uliano will come to the plate. Uliano, the third baseman. He's from Brimmer and May High School, graduated in 2015. This is up the middle, fielded by the second baseman, turns and flipped to the shortstop, got away. And that is going to allow Uliano to reach. And that would have been a fielder's choice, but instead you gotta call that an error on the shortstop. So now two on with one out. And Butera steps in, the cleanup hitter. That one down low. That one inside, 2-0 on Butera. Montero had a sacrifice RBI his last time up, which scored Alex Haslam the only run of the game up to this point. That one low, 3-0. Time from the stretch. Inside, and Butera draws the walk. That is going to load up the bases for Newton. And we're gonna get a timeout here as head coach Derek Johnson, as well as the catcher Zach Jacobs, will come out and talk to Keim with Christian Quigley, the designated hitter, due up. Quigley hit a single, his only time up, in the first inning. For those of you just joining us, we are in the top half of the third inning. A 1-0 lead for Newton over Ashland in their first home game of the season. It's Ashland Legion Post 77 baseball. You're either watching on WACA-TV in Ashland or HCAM Television in Hopkinton. Keim from the stretch, set to deal. And this is hit in the air, and that is going to head over to center field. Runner tags, throw in, and a run will score. And that is going to be a flyout for Quigley, but he gets the job done. That'll make it 2-0 Newton. That one down low. Certainly difficult dealing with the sun here at this field. Wind up and the pitch, and this is crushed over towards left field. And the catch will be made by Porter. And that will be the third out of the inning. To the bottom of the third we go. Ashland trailing Newton. Bottom of the third, Ashland trailing 2-0 as that pitch is in there for a strike to Samir Sharma, the right fielder. His first at bat of the game. Wind up and the pitch up the first baseline, and it is taken care of by the first baseman. A 3 unassisted ground out, one away. Brad Seymour, the center fielder, coming to the plate. The run in the top of the third, scored on a sacrifice flyout by Christian Quigley. Alex Haslam came around to score. So Ashland needs to get the offense going as Anderson deals. There's a strike to Seymour. Wind up and the pitch. And he gets a nice rip on that one, but Bill Sylvie was right there on one knee to make the catch. Right to the second baseman, just great. A great spot for the second baseman, two away. Now Jake Obid will come to the plate. The leadoff hitter for Post 77. Breaking pitch up high, 1-0. Leg lift and the pitch. Down low, 2-0. Anderson deals. There's a strike, 2-1 to Obid. Leg lift and the pitch, swinging strike, nice. Movement on that breaking pitch, good drop on it, 2-2. Anderson deals, fouled away. The 2-2 pitch to Obid. There's strike three, but it got away. Throw down the line, no problem. And that will be out number three for the bottom of the third. To the top of the fourth we go. Ashland trailing 2-0. Top half of the fourth inning as Newton will come back up to the plate with a 2-0 lead. Andrew Kime back out for another inning of work. The 7, 8, and 9 hitters due up for post 440. Brendan Devlin will step in. He flew out his last time up in the second. Kime set to deliver. That one down low. 1-0. Well, Kime's been pitching well today, but a little misfortune in the last inning as there was an error made. As there's a strike to Devlin. And actually that would mean that the run actually would still go down as actually, it would go down as unearned as this is hit up the middle, bobbled by the second baseman, and Devlin's going to reach. So one earned run for Kime and one unearned overall. So Devlin aboard on the error. Mike Gately, the catcher, stepping in and taking a pitch up high. 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike, 1-1. Well, with the direction of the sun here, it would more than likely most affect the hitter. As this is hit in the air over to left field and ranging all the way back towards the fence was Porter, and he made the catch. And nice job by Porter. He's really covering a lot of ground out there, and there's one away. That'll bring up Bill Sylvie, the second baseman. Sylvie lined out his last time up. Kime is set to deliver. That one outside. 1-0. Kime from the stretch. There's a ball two. 1-1 for Newton. That one outside, 3-0. Good amount of lefties in this Newton lineup. As there's a strike. Kime set to deliver the 3-1 pitch. There's strike two. Count now full. Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away. Count remains full. Kime deals, and this is hit in the air to left field. Porter ranging over, he'll make the catch. Two away. Devlin will head back to first. That'll bring up Jack Marsjanic, the shortstop. His third at bat. He is 1-for-2 so far today. Porter certainly keeping busy in left field today. That one down low. He has caught 5 fly balls so far in this game over in left field. time from the stretch. On the ground, first base side, will get by the dive of Obit. Into right field it goes. And the lead runner heading over to third to slide in. He is going to be safe. And that is a good piece of hitting by Marzjanic. A two-out single. Devlin up to third. Alex Haslam to the plate. Center fielder has scored both runs so far in this game. There's strike one. He's reached on a single and a fielder's choice so far. There is warm-up action for Ashland. This is up the middle foul. Excuse me, up the left side line. Time set to deal. That one's foul. Runner will head back to first. Oh, and two on Haslam. Kime deals, runner taking off from first, and this is hit into right field. That'll drop in front of Sharma. Another Newton run around to score. The throw to third to try to get the lead runner was just bobbled by Bates, and he will slide in safely as Haslam pushes up to second on the throw in. So an RBI single for Haslam. Devlin comes around to score. Marzjanic up to third. 3-0 Newton as Keenan Giuliano, the third baseman, steps in. Two outs in the inning. There's strike one, 0-1. We'll see what the leash is with Kime. He's thrown good amount of pitches so far in this one. He's run into a few jams. And this is hit in the air, heading towards right field, and it is caught by Sharma. And that will be the third and final out of the inning, but not before Newton adds another run. It is 3-0 as we head to the bottom of the fourth. Bottom of the fourth inning, Ashland with some work to do, trailing 3-0. Stepping in, Mitch Porter. He'll take ball one. Spencer Anderson pitching a nice game so far, four post 440. He delivers here. And this is lined right at the second baseman. Bill Silvey just constantly in the right place at the right time, one away. I'll bring up Andrew Kime. He plays deep on the infield dirt. And so far it has really been paying off. He has saved a couple of hits that Ashland would have had. That pitch outside, 1-0 to Kime. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away, 1-1. We'll see if Kime stays in the game on the mound. Ashland did have some warm-up action, and they actually still do. So it's very possible they are going to bring in a reliever for the next inning. As this is hit in the air, a high fly ball over to right field, and it is going to be handled by Butera, two away. I'll bring up Zach Jacobs, the catcher. Anderson set to deliver. That one down low, 1-0. And this is up the middle, played on the third base side. Throw to first, not a problem. 5-3 goes Jacobs, and that is the third out of the bottom half of the fourth. To the top of the fifth we go. Newton leading Ashland Legion 3-0. Top half of the fifth inning, a 3-0 lead for Newton over Ashland. Due up are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters. Andrew Keim remains in the game on the mound for post 77 as Mike Butera will step in. He had an RBI sacrifice in the first inning, which scored Haslam, Alex Haslam, the first run of the game. And Keim is set to deal. Upstairs, 1-0. We'll see how long the leash is with Keim. I think if he runs into any more jams, they might take him out of the game. That one down low, 2-0. Three runs and six hits so far for Newton. That pitch down low, 3-0. Keim deals. There's strike one. Leg lift and the pitch. Just inside, ball four. Butera draws the walk. Christian Quigley to the plate. Quigley also has a sacrifice RBI. Had that in the third of driving Alex Haslam. Keim from the stretch, fouled away, 0-1. Keim set to deal. Runner taking off from first, throw up towards second, and it is in time. Great throw by Jacobs as Butera caught stealing, one away. That was just in time. Keim deals, and this is a bloop shot over to the third baseman. Throw to first in time. No, they're going to call him safe. That looked to be in time from here, but the umpire rules safe. And there is a runner aboard for Newton on a single. As Christian Quigley reaches, that'll bring up Don Procopio. Inside. Wind up and the pitch, runner taking off from first. They're going to test Jacobs again. Throw to second, and this time the runner will be safe. Quigley with the stolen base. One and one count to Procopio. Keim deals. And this is a high fly ball over in foul territory. First base side, and it is handled by Obit. Two away. Brendan Devlin to the plate. Keim deals. And this is tattooed into right center. That'll drop in for a hit. Sharma fields it and will be quick on the throw in. but a run will score, and it's 4-0 Newton. An RBI single for Devlin as Quigley comes around for the fourth Newton run of the game. Good piece of hitting there. And Quigley showing off some serious speed as came all the way in from second. And this is hit in the air. It is on the first base side and no one will get to it. And that is actually going to be called a fair ball. So that will be a double by Gately. Devlin will push up to third. And that looked foul, but called fair. Must have dropped just fair before it bounced past the line. But in any case, two on, two outs, Bill Sylvie to the plate. And this is foul. 0-1. The line's certainly difficult to see in the outfield grass. Very faded line. That one down low. And sometimes when you have those faded lines, the umpire will tend to favor the hitter. Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away, 1-2. Keim from the stretch. Down low, runners will hold up. Two and two count to Sylvie, who has a big opportunity to break this game open. Newton already with a 4-0 lead as that one is up high. Full count now. Leadoff hitter due up next, shall Sylvie reach? Keim deals. And this is hit in the air towards center field. And it will be handled by Brad Seymour. And that'll be the third and final out of the top of the fifth, but not before Newton plates yet another run. It is 4-0. Ashland trailing as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the fifth inning, Newton leading Ashland 4-0 as due up for post 77, the 5, 6, and 7 hitters. Mike Messier steps in. Messier 0-for-1 today. And we'll put this one on the ground. Fielded and then dropped by the second baseman, but picks it up, throws it at first in time. One away. Bill Sylvie impressing defensively today for post 440. And that'll bring up Ronan Bates, the third baseman. Made a couple nice plays at second base, and there was able to recuperate from the dropped grounder. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield grass, and it fielded at short. This throw to first will not get there in time, and Bates will reach. And that was a difficult ball to play, so I'm going to score it. Ronan Bates with a single. That'll bring up Michael Krupe with one on and one out. Runner leading off of first. Leg lift and the pitch. Up the middle, fielded by the pitcher. Throw to first, not a problem. Bates pushed up to second. Krupe out on the 1-3. Two-way, Samir Sharma to the plate. Get a time called as Mike Gately, the catcher, will head out to talk to Spencer Anderson. Spencer Anderson pitching a nice game so far. Has only given up two hits to this post 77 lineup. Runner leading off of second. There's a strike. Bates does have a lot of speed, so we'll see if Coach Johnson sends him to third. Big lead there. There's strike two. Oh, and two. Ashland would just love to score their first run of the season. They lost yesterday 1-0 in their first game of the season on the road against Hudson. Anderson deals. There's strike three, and that will do it for the bottom of the fifth. To the top of the six we go, Newton leading Ashland 4-0. New pitcher for post 77, Samir Sharma on the mound. He moves over from right field. And I believe it is Andrew Keim moving over to right field. As that pitch up high, 1-0 to the leadoff hitter, Jack Marsjanic. So Keim went five innings overall, giving up four runs. That one up high. And two of those were earned. And he also gave up nine hits. And this is lined over to the second baseman. Throw to first, not a problem. A 4-3 ground out. That'll bring up Alex Haslam. So overall, not a terrible outing for Keim. Did pretty well, but a couple errors and a couple good battles at the plate. Forced his hand as this is third base side, throw to first, not in time. Nice try by Ronan Bates, but really had a shift down the line to try to get to that one. A single for Haslam, and he is having a nice day. 3-for-4. Overall, has scored two runs and has an RBI. And now Keenan Yuliano will come to the plate. Sharma from the stretch delivers a ball, 1-0. More warm-up action for post 77. Okay, Sharma starts to struggle here in the sixth. Runner leading off of first, Sharma deals. And this is up the first base side, fielded by the second baseman, flipped to first, they'll get one. So Haslam pushed up to second, Yuliano on the 4-3 for the second out, and that'll bring up Mike Butera. There's now a discussion at the mound with Zach Jacobs and Samir Sharma. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Sharma from the stretch, runner leading off of second. There's a strike, 1-1. Sharma set to deal. Runner taking off from second, throw to third, is not in time. A stolen base by the speedy Alex Haslam. Good throw down the line too by Jacobs. Just unable to get it there in time. And we have confirmed that is Andrew Keim in right field. So just a swap with Sharma and Keim. That pitch up high. 2-1 to Butera, who has a nice opportunity here to add another run for Newton. There's a strike. has scored in the last three innings. That one up high, and that is going to draw the walk. So that will put runners on the corners with two outs. Christian Quigley to the plate. He's two for two with a sacrifice RBI. He's also scored a run today. Sharma deals. There's a strike. 0-1. Both runners leading. The lineup and the pitch. Inside, 1-1. Sharma delivers, fouled away. 1-2 to Quigley. Sharma delivers upstairs. Nice cover up by Jacobs. It's 2-2 now to the designated hitter. That one inside, that'll fill up the count. Don Procopio due up next if Quigley reaches. And now we have a stoppage here. And just a infield discussion, it looks like. It's Messier with some words of wisdom for Sharma. Sharma deals. And there's strike three. So Sharma will get the strikeout and keep Newton scoreless in the sixth. But as we head to the bottom of the sixth, Newton leads Ashland 4-0. Bottom of the sixth inning, a 4-0 lead for Newton. Brad Seymour steps in, the center fielder, and he'll take a strike from Spencer Anderson. Anderson set to deal. Leg lift and the pitch. Down low, 1-1. Anderson has pitched a very nice game so far this afternoon. And this is up the middle, fielded by the shortstop, throw to first, pulled the first baseman off the bag. And they are going to call the runner safe. So Seymour reaches on the errant throw, and that'll bring up Jake Obid. First error of the game by Newton. The lefty set to deliver. Checking at first, runner just back safe. Well, if you're Ashland with a runner on, no outs, you really have to just try to get the rally going. There's a strike. 0-1 to Obid. Obid 1-for-2 today. Runner leading off of first once again and taking off. That's fouled away. Ashland is a team that is very aggressive on the base paths. That is certainly a style of head coach Derek Johnson. Anderson set to deliver. There's a called strike, and that is out number one. That'll bring up Mitch Porter. It's the fourth strikeout of the game for Anderson. Wind up and the pitch runner taking off from first once again. The bunt down foul. 0-1. And will they give the runner second base? It appears they will. Must have got there in time. So a stolen base for Seymour. Seymour taking a big lead off of second now. And this is a liner up the middle, fielded by the second baseman. Throw to first is good. So a 4-3 for the second out. Seymour pushed up to third, and that'll bring up Andrew Kime. Post 77 still searching for their first run of the season. As Kime steps in, took over in right field after pitching five innings today. Samir Sharma moved over from right field to the mound. That one down low, 1-0. Zach Jacobs, the catcher, due up next if Kime reaches. Fouled away, 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. And this is a bloop shot fielded by the pitcher. Throw to first, not a problem. A 1-3 ground out for Kime, no harm done. And as we head to the seventh, Newton leading 4-0. HKM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries located at 93 East Main Street. You can find them online at westonnurseries.com. Top half of the seventh inning, Newton trying to add some security, already with a nice, comfortable 4-0 lead. As this is crushed over towards right center, and it is fielded by Brad Seymour, who was playing deep. So one pitch, one out as Procopio flies out. And now Brendan Devlin due up. As the left fielder will step in. Samir Sharma out there for his second inning of work. Pitch down low, 1-0. 6, 7, and 8 hitters this inning for Newton. Sharma deals down low. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air over to center field and handled by Seymour two-way. Mike Gately to the plate. Gately 1-for-3 today, had a double in the fifth. Sharma deals, and they're going to say he got hit by that pitch. Must have got a piece of him. So now Bill Sylvie steps in. Tough to see it from here. Sharma from the stretch. Upstairs, 1-0. So Gately on with two outs. Sharma deals, check swing, did he hold? Strike, 1-1. Sharma deals, upstairs. 2-1. Bill Sylvie 0 for 3 so far today, looking for his first hit. Upstairs, 3 and 1. Lefty steps back in and awaits the pitch. On the ground, up the middle, fielded by the shortstop, and he'll take it himself over to second base for the 6 unassisted force out. And that will wrap up the top half of the 7th. To the bottom of the 7th we go. Ashland down to their final 3 outs, trailing 4-0. Bottom of the 7th, post 77 down to their final 3 outs, trailing 4-0 against Newton post 440. New pitcher on the mound to close it out for Newton, Brian Coker, as he is set to deal to Zach Jacobs, the catcher. And the first pitch up high, 1-0. Spencer Anderson pitched a gem today for Newton. Wind up and the pitch upstairs. Coker set the deal. That one inside. And there's 4 straight balls. Jacobs draws the walk. Certainly surprising to not see Anderson stay in and try to finish the game. He's pitching pretty smoothly through this one. There's a strike to Messier. Spencer Anderson went 6 innings, gave up no runs, 2 hits, had 4 strikeouts. Pretty good line. Pitching a great game. Anderson, a 2015 graduate of Newton North in his final season in Legion baseball. Jacobs leading off of first, as this is hit in the air, left side foul. 0-2. Ronan Bates due up next. The pitcher now, Brian Coker, graduated this year from Newton South. Runner taking off from first, but time was called. I think he's going to have to go back. Messier will step back in. Coker delivers, runner taking off from first, throw up, and not in time. No tag, and Jacobs is safe with the stolen base. So a runner on second, no outs for post 77. One and two to Messier. Runner leading off of second, and that is off of Messier, hit by pitch. Well, now you got 2 on with no outs and Ronan Bates coming up. Interesting situation here as Gately will talk to Coker. Well, and the way Anderson was throwing, I mean, he didn't throw a whole lot of pitches. Surprising that he's still not in this ball game. But Newton North with a lot of games coming up, or excuse me, Newton with a lot of games coming up due to Newton North High School. Went deep into the playoffs and had to postpone some of the Legion games due to not having enough players. So a crowded schedule, perhaps just giving Anderson, an extra inning of rest. There's warm-up action for Newton. As there's a strike, one and one to Bates. Coker set to deal. Upstairs, two and one. Excuse me, one and two. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. Post 77 looking for their first run of this season. As we are in the bottom of the seventh, Ashland trailing 4-0 against Newton. On the ground, third base side, picked up by the third baseman, throw to first, and they get the out. So that is a 5-3, and I am not quite sure why the third baseman, or actually that was not a forced play. But actually, no, it was a forced play. Not quite sure why the third baseman didn't step on third before he threw it across the diamond. That is going to remain a mystery to me. Is that pitch outside? Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away, one and one. So now you have runners on second and third for post 77. With one out. Tying run on deck. Leg lift and the pitch inside. Two and one. Set to deal. There's a strike. The 2-2 pitch coming from Coker. Inside, full count now. Wind up and the pitch. Down low, and there's ball four. So now you have bases loaded. Samir Sharma coming to the plate. And now the Newton head coach going to come out and have a discussion with Coker. Well, post 77, not done yet. Still a big opportunity here. As James Greeley, the head coach for post 440, having a discussion with Coker. And you got Sharma coming up. He's 0-2 so far today. He only got one out, bases loaded. And a huge opportunity here. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away, 0-1. Will we see a post 77 miracle here on opening night at home? That's fouled away towards the Newton bench. A home opening night, I should say. Second game of the season. Ashland opened yesterday against Hudson. A great pitcher's duel, which resulted in a 1-0 loss for Ashland. Coker deals, on the ground, up the middle, and that's going to get by the reach of the second baseman, and one run is in to score. Post 77 has their first run of this season on an RBI single by Samir Sharma. Messier up to third, Krupe up to second. Bases loaded, one out, and it is now a 4-1 game. Seymour steps in. There's a strike. Inside, 1-1. That would certainly be a shame for Spencer Anderson after he just had this great pitching performance for it to get blown here. There's a strike, 1-2. Coker set the deal. Just outside, 2-2. One run in for Post 77. Bases loaded, one out. Fouled away. Count remains 2-2 on Brad Seymour. Line up and the pitch. There is strike three. Post 77 now down to their final out as Jake Obid will come up to the plate. Obid, one of four Holliston High School players on Post 77. There's strike one. Swinging strike, 0-2. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away. Obid stays alive. Count remains 0-2. Wind up and the pitch. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield. Grass fielded at short. Throw to first is low, but in time. A 6-3 ground out for Obid, and that will do it. Post 77 does threaten. They get a run in the bottom of the seventh, but they come up short by a final score of 4-1. A great pitching performance by Spencer Anderson for Newton as he went the first six innings giving up no runs on two hits and had four strikeouts. And Newton scored a run in the first, third, fourth, and fifth inning. And they take the game 4-1. And what was a good battle here on home opening night for Ashland Post 77. Ashland scores one run on three hits and commits two errors, while Newton scores four runs. And they do it on 10 hits and commit one error as Newton gets the 4-1 victory over Ashland Post 77. Newton improves to 1-0 overall as this was their opening night here today. Ashland falls to 0-2, but certainly a long way to go here in the Legion baseball season. For Connor Donovan on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Ashland Legion Post 77 Baseball on HCAM Television or WACA TV in Ashland. Thanks for watching and enjoy the rest of your day, everybody.